Hello everyone, my name is Arohi and welcome to my channel. So guys, today I'll talk about CycleGAN. So today's tutorial is divided into three parts. First of all, I'll show you what are CycleGANs, and then I'll show you the application of CycleGANs, and after that we'll discuss the model architecture of CycleGAN. I'll also show you the loss function we use in CycleGAN. So let's begin. So CycleGAN is used for image-to-image translations. And image-to-image translation simply means generating synthetic images. Synthetic images means artificially manufactured images, okay? So image-to-image translation means generating new synthetic version of a given image with specific modifications. For example, translating a night scene into a day scene, or translating a sunny day into a rainy day, or translating a summer landscape into a winter landscape. Okay, so what CycleGAN does is it basically capturing the characteristics of one image domain, and then it figure out how these characteristics can be transferred to the another image domain. Okay, so guys, before CycleGAN also there are other models. Using them we can perform this image to image translation, but those model use dataset in the form of pairs. So for example, if you want to do translations on night to day images, then you need a pair of image, the night and the daytime of one particular image. Okay, so these kind of pairs were required in those previous models. But in CycleGAN, CycleGAN does not require a data set in the form of paired images. So for example, if you want to translate a night scene into a day scene, then we don't need a training data set which have a pair of these images. Okay, so basically CycleGANs are trained on unsupervised data. So by unsupervised data, it simply means you need, if you want to do translation of nighttime into a daytime, then you need two separate folder. One folder will have the images of nighttime and other folder will have the images of daytime, and they can be any random images. We don't need a pair of those images. Okay, so this is how CycleGAN work. Okay, and then applications of CycleGAN, where we can use CycleGAN. So with the help of CycleGAN we can do lots of interesting tasks, like photo enhancement we can perform, we can do image colorization, we can generate photographs from paintings, then we can perform season transfer, style transfer. So all these kind of things we can do with the help of CycleGAN. The only thing which you need is source data set and the target data set. And by saying this source data set and the target data set, I simply mean to say two folder. One folder will have the images of for example a nighttime, and other folder will have images of daytime, and they can be any random images. Okay, now let me show you the layer architecture, the model architecture of CycleGAN. Okay, so CycleGAN have two GAN networks. Okay, in CycleGAN we have two GAN networks, and the generator for, let's take one example and I'll show you this model architecture as per that example. Okay, so I am going back to the same example. For example we want to translate day images into a night images. Okay, so the generator of first GAN network will take the day image and it will try to translate it into a night image, and then the generator of second GAN network will take the night image and try to translate into a day image. Okay, and then we have discriminator in both the GAN networks. Okay, and the task of discriminator is to figure out it will find out the image which we are giving to a discriminator, whether that image is generated by a generator or that image is a original image. Okay, so discriminator is basically a binary classifier. It will figure out whether the given image is a real image or a fake image. Fake image simply means the image generated by a generator. Okay, so this is what it doing. And then We use cycle consistency laws in CycleGANs to know the difference, you know, between the real data set and the fake data set. So how it works is, so the input to a first GAN network is a day image, right? And it is generating night image, okay? Input to a first GAN network is a day image and it is generating a night image. Now, the night image generated by first GAN network, we will give that image to the second GAN network as an input, okay? And then that second GAN network, which has an input, and that input is a that input is generated by a first GAN network, okay? So what I'm trying to say is, input to first GAN network is a day image, and the generator of first GAN network will generate a night image. That night image will become input to a second GAN network, and then this second GAN network will generate a day image on the basis of the night image which is given to the second GAN network by this first GAN network. Now, the output of second GAN network is a day image and the input to first GAN network is a day image. Now, what we want is, now generator models will get updated according to the reduce in the difference between these images, the input to the GAN 1 and the output of the GAN 2, right? So basically we are calculating this loss. How we are calculating this cycle consistency loss between the image input to first GAN network and the image output by GAN 2, and the generator models are updated accordingly to the reduce in the difference between these two images. So this is how CycleGAN work. So guys, I hope this video is helpful. Thank you for watching.